That's a foster rest. Let's remain in the East Rand. Our reporter Marie Ketla Mohlabe is in Katlehong in Ekurhuleni. Marie Ketla, tell us the latest wherever you are and give us a sense of what is happening now.
Yeah, good evening to you, Tebi. So not far from where my colleague Ntata Khatlani was earlier today in Chris Hani Mall, we are now back at Letsoho Mall. I'm sure you probably recall the running battles that actually ensued on Monday between police and some of the looters here. And I can tell you that when we arrived here, we also found a mob-up operation having been conducted. And as you can see just behind me, some of them refuse bags being filled with trash as a result of that looting incident that took place on Monday and Tuesday. And you'd also recall that this is where a body of one of the residents was actually found on Monday. But I mean, this is a mall that has got about 48 shops, Tebi, so we understand that it has hired over 1,000 employees. But I can tell you that many of those employees are now at home wondering what's going to happen tomorrow. I've got some of them here, and they're just going to talk to us about how they are affected. Lebohang, you're just one of the fast food outlet employees at this mall. Just talk to us about how you have been affected ever since this incident.
This thing even affected a whole because of hona jwale ke sokola lo batla borotho, and I'm very very disappointed ka ntho etsa tseng mo shopping center letso because of go mongwa ba sebetse ya sebetsa mona le Debonairs letso. So ke struggle a whole because of ha ke tsebe ho sane na o tloetsa lang ka nna because of shopping center ne le yone e kgona go ke be di jo tafuleng ne ke kgona go reka borotho. Now I'm struggling. If I want bread, I must go to Albertine. If I want a bread, so it's really affect me a lot.
And how far is Alberton from here?
It's too far. It's too far.
And your employer, have they managed to talk to you about a way forward after this devastation?
Yeah, I'm talking with my employer. We are chatting it on WhatsApp. So they are very affected a lot because of babande ba ipotsa go batla pata di rente kang. So they manage go ba khona pata di rente ba romela chelete mo mahaheng. So this thing ya loot at the shop is very affecting a lot. So yeah, go se bhloko haholo. So I'm pleading to the people of South Africa, they must stop looting their shops. Yeah, I'm pleading for the people of South Africa, please, let's stop looting the shop because it's really affecting the community, it's really affecting the economy of South Africa. Yeah, it's so bad to see the shopping center, like Letsoho Shopping Center, one of the busy shopping centers in Katlehong. Yeah, and it's a busy shopping center in Katlehong.
So. Indeed. Sabelo, you are a security officer here, and we found you with some of your colleagues trying to guard this mall. But talk to me, you are also affected.
Yes, ngi affecteke kakhulu, siphazamiseke kakhulu thina sonke nama colleagues wami because besingazi ukuthi kumele senzeni. Senze konke okusemandleni sizama ukuvikela le shopping center, but sathola ukuthi inumber yabantu beyila ibizohlasela le shopping center. Yeah, si ngamela ngaphezulu asangakwazi ukuthi senze manje, bagcina bengenile ba affecta thina ngaphakathi ne shopping center iyonke. So siphatheke kabuhlungu kakhulu nabasebenzi engisebenza nabo njengabantu bebethanda ukuvikela le shopping center futhi besibeka ukudla phekwe tafula. Njengabanye bethu asiqhamuka emakhaya ehlukahlukene, singama orphan, asinabo abazali, but le shopping center beyisiza ngoba besazi ukuthi mayiphela inyanga sizokwazi ukuthumela ukudla emakhaya, abantwana badle baqhubeke nempilo. Sishayeke kakhulu. Yes.
And then what's the way forward now? Go tlo diregang le tlo ba le farm le tlo ba le dirang bo sho go ka ofela go tloga le gone go fitla go sasa mohlomongwe beke towards the weekend as well.
Yes, but njama manje isima senze makhulu because asazi nanokuthi ukudla sikuthole kuphi. Because nalaya ama truck shop la city siyangakhona ufica ukuthi akudla kukho. Sihlupheka nje sinjena nje akuna nix. Yes.
Thanks so much. Sabelo is one of the security officers here at Letsoho Mall, and basically what he's saying is that this is their livelihood, this is their source of income, this is where they get to actually support their families. Tsebiso is also saying that they have been actually trying to stand out here just to guard this mall, but on an empty stomach. And that's simply because many of the shops around here are affected. They are not able to buy any food in order for them to keep standing throughout the night. But they do not have a choice. They're just going to be here throughout the night, tomorrow, over the weekend, in order to just keep an eye on what's left here at the mall.
Thank you, Marie Ketla. Sad state of affairs, which we're seeing in many parts of the country. Many communities reporting that they've run out of fuel, their fears of fuel running out as well. Government, of course, calling on people to not panic by saying that they are ensuring the stability in terms of supply of fuel and of food as well.